Hello, everyone. Ahoy, vysčiny. Dobrý ráno, dobrý poledne, dobrý večer, dobrý den. Doufám, že dnes vysčiny máte úžasný den. Já jsem Lex a vidíte u mého nového videa z GTA 5. Hello, everyone. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good day. Hope you're all having an amazing day today. My name is Lex and welcome back to some more GTA 5. I hope that check intro was not that bad. I actually just did that on the first attempt. Granted, I did try several times before starting to record, but I think I did that okay. So sorry to any of the Czech viewers if that was terrible, but hopefully that was okay. So today, well, I'm following a car that you might recognize as not being part of this game, but a car that you probably do recognize anyway. And that is because the car in front is from GTA 4. And in fact, so is this car that I'm driving right now. Let me just change the view here. Look at this. It is the Vapid Uranus back in GTA 5. This is a massive, massive car pack that I'm showing you today that adds a huge bunch of cars from GTA 4 ported through to GTA 5. And I cannot contain my excitement. I've just had a quick browse through the cars that are in here and it is fantastic. And the amazing thing is, some of these cars even have modifying parts for it. This car is in fact fully modified. I've got a new front end on there, I've got new side skirts, I've got a big spoiler, I've changed the paint, got some nice wheels on here. It looks absolutely stunning. But before then, there's going to be some comments on the screen. If you would like your comments and questions featured, you can leave them in the comments section below. I'll pick some at random and I'll feature them in the next video. And also, don't forget you can follow me on Twitter at Figure8 if you would like to keep up to date with things that are going on, especially as I'm not updating sort of daily. You can get a better idea of why videos aren't up or what I'm doing if you follow me on Twitter. So just if you want to keep up to date with what's going on with the channel, Twitter is the way to go. And also you can just check me tweeting random things like quotes from random TV shows or whatever's going on. I often tweet a load of old rubbish. Or retweet a load of old rubbish, which is always fun. Okay, let's try and find somewhere to park. I need to find somewhere that's close to a Los Santos Customs because some of these are modifiable and I want to see which ones are. This might be a long video. I guess you could probably already tell at that point because you could probably see how much of this video is left. But whoop, hopefully we can try and get this through as quick as possible. But there is just so much to look at. Oh, it's so exciting. And one thing to note is all of these cars, in fact, I'm not sure if it's some or all, but most of the cars can actually spawn in the world. So if we try and drive around, I want to see if I could find a car that shouldn't be here. I think that stallion should be there. That stallion. Aha, this one. No. Oh, no, no. That one should be in this game. It looks very similar to one that shouldn't, though. Maybe one of these. No. Oh, God damn it. Actually, it was really easy to find some earlier, but now I can't find any of them. Okay, now I'm back in town and I've swapped cars. Now we can see some more of these additional cars like this baby right here. This is the old classic Cheetah. Check this out. This is, I actually can't remember this in GTA 4, but this front end does look familiar. But this rear end, this shape is very familiar to anyone who has played any of the older GTA games. Absolutely amazing. In fact, that one right there, that's another one. This is a four-door version of the... Is that the Sultan? No, that's not the Sultan. It's a four-door version of something that we have in this game. Oh, what is it called? Oh, it's the Shafter. It's a four-door version. Yet, that is another one that is added in this mod. As you can see, they're all spawning in with the traffic, which just makes this so much cooler. Okay, so I'm going to pull in somewhere down here relatively close to LS Customs. Oh, in fact, that car park looks absolutely perfect. Let's go in there and check out some of these cars. And by the way, if you're wondering why I'm playing as Franklin today, I've kind of got bored of Michael. I realized that there is actually three characters in this game, so I thought I'd mix it up, especially as we're going to be looking at cars today, and he's supposed to be the car driver of this game. So let's just go to vehicle spawning, go to added vehicles menu. I'm going to put a link in the description on how you can get these, this menu and this little extra menu so you can install these cars or so you can put these cars into the game and spawn them in properly. I'll put links to those in the description below. So let's look at the first one. We have the Albany Buccaneer. Check this out. So this is... See, some of these are actually sort of the earlier versions of cars that we now have in this game where they've been sort of improved and modernized or just made to look a little bit better. because this does look very familiar to one of the cars that is already in here, and I think we do actually have an Albany Buccaneer. Let's see if I can spawn it in, actually. You see, there we go. Look, we do have the Buccaneer and the Buccaneer Custom, in fact. So that is what it looks like. Ah, see, there is actually a big difference. That's interesting. So this is what the modern Buccaneer looks like, and that's what the old classic Buccaneer looks like. And what is amazing is we can now have both of these together. Unlike these mods that add the real cars, I know they're exciting, but just having a collection of all the cars from GTA 4 in GTA 5 is just so, so damn cool. So there we go. There is the Buccaneer. Now let's check out the Albany Cavalcade FXT. Oh, wow. Okay, so that is the old Cavalcade with the pickup truck bit on the back. You can definitely, that is definitely very GTA 4. I remember driving this so much. But the thing is, all of these are so familiar that you sort of think, well, aren't these already in GTA 5? Because some of these, I think we do have something very similar to this again in GTA 5. But that is obviously some of the things that Rockstar does, is they just continue the cars and redesign them slightly. So all of these are going to feel very familiar, but these are unique to GTA 4 and they weren't in GTA 5, at least not to my knowledge. Next is the Albany Esperanto. Oh, okay. Well, we're going to have some problems with this. Let's just... Oh, oh, there we go. Now, this car you should recognize as the first car you drive in GTA 4. I almost said GTA 5 then. It's I'm just so used to saying GTA 5 now. This is the first car that you see in GTA 4 that Nico drives to the taxi rank thing. Check that out. Obviously, let's just... Let's try and fix that up a bit. There we go, all repaired. See, check that out. And also, with all of these cars, if we go to the interior, they all have interiors that have been taken out of GTA 5, including all working dials and steering wheels. So look at that. We have the steering wheel that works, we have the speedo, and we have the rev counter all working. So it's brought them all up to date. Oh, look, there's a taxi. There's an old GTA 4 taxi there. Oh, yes, it's so fun seeing these in the wild. That's what makes it really fun. In fact, you might not even want to spawn them in with the trainer. You might just want to install this and just sort of find them as they drive around. I guess that just makes it more fun. So the next one is the Albany Presidente. And by the way, I am going... Oh, yeah, also, they have all the radio selections and everything. In fact, let's just go back out of this. If I go to... How do I change the radio in this thing? I haven't used the radio on GTA 5 in a long time. I think I disabled it. So it's going to say radio off, but if I did have the radio all sort of working, it would show the radio as well, which is so damn cool. So yeah, I am going to try and modify some of these, but if I just look through all the standard ones first, then I'm going to go back afterwards and try and find some that might be modifiable. So here we have the Presidente. Then we have the Battle of Gay Tony variation of the Presidente, which, oh, it's got bigger wheels. It's got a slightly better front end and a different bonnet. And it's got a little spoiler on the back. Slightly different, slightly different. So we've even got variations of these same cars, which is pretty cool. And then we have a police version of the Presidente as well. Nice. Does all the lights work? Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Okay, that is awesome. That is awesome. So the next one is the Anis Pinnacle. Here we go. I need to try and remember to take this menu off each time. I know I'm going to keep forgetting to do that. Look at that. Now, that is kind of reminding me of a Honda Accord. Honda Accord is what I want to say about this car. I think that's what it's based on. That's the sort of feel that I'm getting from that back there, but I could be wrong. Although, actually, the rest of this does look like a very American-styled car, actually. Again, all of this, all working interior, all working dials. Oh, that is so cool. And it even has, look, there's the parking brake light as well. Oh, that's fantastic. So there we go. There's that one. There's so many to get through. I know I'm gonna skip through them and go, there's this one, there's this one, there's this one. So I can only apologize for the not being too much in the way of, I don't know, but I just want to go through all of these cars. So the next is the Benefactor Feltzer, which we all know and love from this game. But of course, this is the not so tuned version with the really boring looking front. And this is, wow, it's so weird to see this when we're so used to seeing what's in GTA 5. Oh, wow. In fact, I'm very curious to see what this has in Los Santos Customs. We'll definitely be checking that out in a minute. So the next one is the Benefactor Shafter, which is... Oh, that's the one that we saw earlier, isn't it? This is the four-door version of the Shafter that... Let's try and find the original one that we've got in GTA 5. Oh, yes, of course. We have loads of different Shafters in this one, don't we? We have the normal, the V12, the long wheelbase, the V12 armored, and the long wheelbase one. Wow, we have so many in GTA 5 now. Ah, this has actually got a different front end, but I recognize the back end of this one from another car. So they must have changed all the names. That's why some of these aren't recognizable. I'm not sure I'll be able to find the one. Is it this one? No, it's not the intruder. Okay, I definitely recognize that back end from a car in GTA 5. You guys might have to tell me because I readers can't remember. But it definitely, I feel like there's a two-door version of that in GTA 5. So the next one is the Bravado Feroci. Oh dear. Oh dear. Hang on, if I spawn another one in. No, and again, and again. I'm going to keep spawning it until I'm, there we go. We've got one that's not. Let's just move back. And again, a really nice standard looking car, but it just fits in so nicely with the GTA series and all the other GTA cars. It looks pretty damn cool. I really like this. This has definitely got a lot of JDM design cues to it. That's almost sort of like Lexus GS at the front a bit. There we go. Then we also have the Fly US version of the Bravado Feroci. There we go. With the plain sort of, what are they, just steel wheels with little caps on them. And all the Fly US decals as well, which is pretty cool. Then we have the Brute Bus, which is just another version of the bus. But again, this is a slightly older bus. And this is a huge welcome because the buses in this game are sort of boring. They're sort of modern. It's nice to have a few of the old ones thrown in there. So that's really cool. Then we have the Mr. Tasty. And I don't think there is one of these in GTA 5, is there? We've always had an ice cream van, but I can't remember. Well, I'm going to have to go and find it now. Well, I'm looking through the services menu and I can't see one. So maybe we don't have one in GTA 5. Well, that would be good because we now have one. Oh, hang on. I've got to test the horn. Oh, it doesn't have the noise and the music. Oh, that's a huge shame. I wanted it to go. Well, I guess you'll have to fill that noise in for yourself or maybe just record what I just did and play it back. If you're weird like that. Okay, let's move on to the next one. So the next one is the Brute Stockade. Oh, this is the Stockade Los Santos Police Department one. And it's even changed all the graphics, so it's not New York, which obviously wouldn't fit in. Or actually, it'd be Liberty City, wouldn't it? But now it says Los Santos, or at least LS. So that is a really cool addition. There we go. And then we also have the Noose version, which is looking pretty nice. Noose. And then we have the Buckingham Quoi, which is a helicopter. Oh, it's a plane. It's a plane. And it won't really fit in. Oh, it's even got more than one decal as well. So there we go. There's the Buckingham Quoi, which is blown up again. There's another one. There's another one. There's another one. Looks like there's three different graphical selections. Then there is this one, which is... Oh. Okay, well, spawning in too much shit is going to break GTA, isn't it? Of course, you idiot. Okay, we're back in. And as a note, guys, when you've got this many add-ons, you can expect some sort of bad things to happen sometimes. It's just the way the game runs. So let's just go back. And the next one is the Canis Bodhi. Now, this one, from what I remember, was not in GTA 4. But this is another addition. This is a clean version of the Bodhi that we have in GTA 5. It's just, it's a version that I feel that we've always should have had. And maybe Rockstar might add this in the future. I don't know. But it's nice that we can now have a clean version that doesn't have all the rust and the bad paint. And it's all got chrome and stuff. And it looks pretty awesome. So that's a nice little addition, even though it's not really GTA 5 themed. Or at least, not to my knowledge. I can't remember this one being in GTA 5. So the next one is the D-Class Merit. Oh my god. Okay, so we're already on line one, almost finished. Then we've got line two. Then we've got another line. And then we've got half of another line. We've got so many to skip through. So this is the D-Class Merit. This is the standard lot, like the bog standard car of GTA 5. So we also have it in the police car format. Like that, even with, oh wow, it's even got all the rails and grating and stuff for the passengers in the back, which is amazing. And then we also have the taxi version, like that one, which is pretty cool. There's all of those D-Class ones done. I don't know if any of those are modifiable. We're gonna try and discover some of those at the end. So the next one is the D-Class Premier, which is the Max Payne 3 variant. Because, yeah, I definitely can't remember this being in GTA 4 either. But this is obviously based on the, oh, what is it called? It's the Chevy Caprice? Isn't it? I think it's called the Chevy Caprice. I could be completely wrong, but I think that is what it is known as in the real world, or that is what it's supposed to be based on. So that's a nice little extra. Another car that you would probably see a lot of in America. Or actually, maybe you probably wouldn't anymore. Maybe most of these are all scrapped now, but these used to be like the police cars back in the day. In fact, is there a police car version? Oh, there is not. Okay. Well, that was the De-Class Premiere. Then we have the Rancher, which is pretty nice. Not really big on the cabin area. Pretty short looking, is what I'm trying to say. But it's got some stuff in the back. Looks pretty cool. And look, as I've just got to this intersection, there's one car there that is supposed to be in GTA 4. There we go. In fact, there's the De-Class thingy that we just looked at, which is pretty cool. Sitting there in regular traffic. Oh, and one of those taxis as well. Nice. So the next one is the De-Class Saber, which is this one, which we have in Donk version now, I think, don't we? Yes, but it's got a different name. It's now called the Faction, but I think that's supposed to be the same car. As you can see, the shape is the same. They've just obviously changed all the names and stuff around. But I quite like this old version. I especially like that red interior. That's really nice. But after this one is the Rusty version. As we can see here, this is the car that we were following right at the start of this video. And of course, this is even made to be like the old Rusty cars in this game as well. So it even like took a while to start, you might have noticed just then, because Franklin pointed it out, which is really cool. You could even hear like the engine sounding really rattly as well. That's a really nice feature. So now this is another one, just like the Candice Bodie, if I could ever say that right. This is another car from GTA 5 that has been slightly tweaked for this mod as well. And this is the unarmed version of the JB700, which is just another nice addition. Then we have the Debauchee Super G. No. If we get to the end of the street. Oh, it's going to crash, isn't it, if I keep spawning these in. That's a bad idea. Okay, repaired vehicle, and I've gone. Yeah, here we go. This is the Debauchee Super GT, which is supposed to look like the old Aston Martins. And again, it looks absolutely lovely. And if we go to the interior, there we go. We have a nice modern interior in this one, and it's even got the Debauchee badge on the wheel. Wow. There is so much detail that has gone into these. This is absolutely phenomenal. So the next one is the Dinka Chavos, which I think is a bike. No, it is not. Okay, maybe I'm thinking of something else. But there we go. Here is the Dinka Chavos, which is a nice little compact car. Something that I imagine might have some tuning parts for, so we'll definitely be checking that out in a minute. Then we have the Dinka Double T Custom. And now this one's a bike. That's why I remember the Dinka name. There we go. That is a Double T Custom. Just a regular bike, really. I don't really know much about bikes, but that back end does look very short. I guess that's the interesting part of that bike. Then we have actually what I would say is one of my favorite cars from GTA 4. And that is the Dinka Hakumai, because this just looks so much like a late 80s, early 90s car. It's very Prelude styled, but it's a four-door. If that was the Prelude four-door? Oh dear. How have I forgotten that detail? But anyway, I think this looks absolutely amazing. It looks like an old classic Japanese car, especially with those little front lights as well. Always cool. I really like this one. This one we're definitely going to be checking out in Los Santos Customs in a little while as well. So the next one is the Dinka Perennial. Ah, which is the minivan with the big, massive moonroof. Look at that. Oh, wow. I don't think there is a car with a moonroof in this game, actually. And then we also have the Fly US version as well, which doesn't have the moonroof, sadly. But it does have a little thing on the roof. Does it... Oh, wow. It even lights up. Oh, look at the detail that's gone into this. This is fantastic. Oh, look. And there's even one of those Super GTs that's just driven up by an AI. I love this. I am so... This is, to me, probably one of my favorite must-have mods of the moment. Because this is just fantastic. If you have not downloaded this already, just go and download it. If you have OpenIV, you only need to use the package installer. And it can install it for you with the file that you download. It is so incredibly easy to install that it is a must-have for anyone on PC. Sadly, those of you with consoles, I'm going to be missing out, I'm afraid. Right, let's move on to the next one then. And the next one is the Dundry Admiral. I really need to start speeding these things up now. So here we go. Here's the Dundry Admiral. Let's just try and turn around because it's going to get a bit dark down there. Oh, look, there's another one of those. Is that the Hakumai? That's not the Hakumai. But it's one of those Dinka. That's the Dinka Chavros, isn't it? And next up we have the Stretch, which is just the Stretch version of the Admiral. Again, these were pretty basic cars in GTA 5. No, I mean GTA 4. God damn it. I probably messed that up already and just not even realized. I actually have noticed it that time. The next one is the Emperor Locus, which is this nice little car. I love these little cars. They're just so generic, but so different to what we have in GTA 5. Again, I absolutely love this thing. Is that that? Is that different? Actually, I think that was from the latest DLC, actually, that one. That one. Yeah, I think that's from the latest DLC. So the next one that we have is the Faggio, which is very similar to the one we have in GTA 5 already. But I assume it's going to be slightly different. In fact, let's spawn in the other Faggio so we can see what the difference is. Ah, the Faggio in this one was an old scooter. Okay, so that brings back the modern scooters into GTA. So that is a nice addition. I'm liking that. I completely forgot about the fact that we didn't have a modern scooter. Nope, looking through this list, there is no modern scooter. That is fantastic. That is a definite welcome addition. Even though I didn't realize that we didn't have it, now that I know it was missing, now I want it back. So this is great. So the next one is the Grotti Cheetah Classic variant that we found towards the start. Oh yeah, check that out. I love this thing. Absolutely love this thing. We'll definitely be taking this one to Ellis Customs soon as well, because I think there's going to be some cool stuff for this one. So the next one is the Grotti Turismo. Oh yeah, I forgot about this one. Oh, let's look at the interior of this one. This is nice. So this is, oh dear, okay, well that interior definitely doesn't match up with the door cards, sadly, but it doesn't really matter. This is based on the Ferrari 360, maybe? I think that's what it's based on. I can't remember, but again, it's another supercar. Oh, what was that? What was that car? Has it despawned? I think it's despawned. Oh, it hasn't despawned. What is it? What is it? Is that the, oh, that's the Hakumai, isn't it? Yeah, the Hakumai just looks so damn cool. I love that thing. Definitely love that thing a lot more than this, but this is just a nice welcome addition anyway. Next up, we have the HVY APC. Oh my god. Oh my god, it even has weapons on it. Holy shit! Oh wow, okay. Oh, fantastic. I love this thing. In fact, I don't think this weapon is even in this game, is it? Do any of the vehicles in this game have a weapon that sort of fires like that? Because that doesn't seem very familiar. In fact, is that one of those Turismos we just spawned in? I think it is. It is indeed. Let's blow it up. Oh, no, no. Don't get away from me. Get back here. There we go. It's actually very hard to control with a controller. I don't know how anyone could play on a console, really. I only use it for the driving. Well, this is absolutely fantastic. Can we shoot something else with the other one? Oh, no, we've only got that weapon. That's it. There is no other selection. Okay. Oh, we even had the lights there. Nice. I love this thing. What's it like on the inside? Oh, it's just going to show us from that. Okay. There we go. Well, that's pretty damn amazing. I'm in love with that as well. So the next one is the HVY Brickade. Interestingly, we just had the Brickade. Ah, this is slightly different. Oh. Oh. Oh, my God. Okay, so that's this one that's even got the protected wheels. It's just a big, massive box with wheels. What's inside like? Oh, my God. Okay, so this is a truck interior with a screen and all the grated windows and stuff as well. That is damn cool. I love that thing. I'm going to probably say that I love most of these, but it is so true. I am just infatuated with this mod right now, or this collection of mods. So the next up is the Imponte, as it's rather called, not the Impontante, as I was about to say, the DFB90. Oh. I don't remember this one. I don't remember this one at all. That looks very Saturn on the front end, actually, or maybe a bit Pontiac. Ah, I actually don't recognize this one at all. What's it like on the inside? Oh, this actually looks pretty nice. Yeah, I don't remember this one at all. I don't remember that back end in the slightest, but it has been a long time since I played GTA 4. So maybe that was one of the generic ones that I just sort of missed out on. Or maybe that's another one that was added for Max Payne. I don't know, but it doesn't have a note by it. So the next one is the Imponte Phoenix short variant, which is very similar to ones that we have in this game already, but it does look a bit different as well. In fact, the front definitely looks different. So this is based on the Trans Am, I think. Looks very Trans Am-y. Again, just a nice, cool, old muscle car. In fact, do these count as muscle cars? I'm pretty sure, like, most American cars had big V8s in them, which is what I would say is a muscle car. Does this count? Did a Trans Am actually count as a muscle car? I guess you guys can let me know in the comments. What is wrong with this car up here? Oh, okay, it just didn't spawn in. Oh, it's one of those! Wow, looks a lot different in beige. So the next car is the Inverto Coquette, made by Inverto, which is not the company that makes the Coquette in this game, from what I know. So this is the old Coquette back from GTA 4. I need to compare this with the ones from GTA 5 because I can't remember now what ones we had. Ah, so the Coquette that we have in this one is the modern one. Okay, and then we also have the Stingray version. So that's added the older sort of 90s Corvette back into GTA 5, which is pretty nice. So the next car is the Karen Sultan Coupe, which I'm confused about because I thought this was already in here. What's different about this one? Hang on, was the other one a four-door? Hang on. Ah, so the Sultan in GTA 5 was a four-door. And then they brought back the RS with the... I remember now. So that's going to bring the coupe version back into GTA 5, which is pretty cool. Yeah, two-door, four-door, and then we also have the souped-up RS version as well. That is awesome. I am just, yeah, even though it's these things, like, you don't really know you want them until you've got them, and now it's like, yeah, of course. Now, of course we needed that in GTA 4. Or GTA 5, rather. Oh, God, I'm going to confuse these so much. Okay, next one is the Liberty Chop Shop Lycan. Now, this must have been from one of those episodes with all the bikes in it. I can't remember what it was called now. I can't remember what the old episodes were called. I can only remember Battle of Gay Tony, but there was the other one that had all the bikers. So this brings back some of the bikes that the bikers had, which is pretty nice. There is some more as well that are from this one. We also have the Lycan Custom, which is, it's just got flames on the side of it. Then we've got the Nightblade, which is pretty nice. And then we've got the Zombie. Oh, wow. Okay, I like that. That is really cool. And then we have the Maibatsu Vincent, which is another one of these generic sort of 90s Japanese-looking cars. In fact, that front end, to me, screams Galant. Absolutely screams Galant. Yeah. Okay, I like this because it has a Galant front end on it. I like this one now. So was Maibatsu supposed to be like Mitsubishi? Because it's got the Tsu in it? I don't know. That's an interesting thought, actually. Again, I definitely want to check that out in a Pay and Spray. Not a Pay and Spray. In a Los Angeles Customs in just a moment as well. So the next one is apparently not working, but it is supposed to be a Noose Patriot. I'm sure there might be an update at some point that we'll get that working. Then we have the MLT Packer. Oh! Oh! and that's just a big sort of tow truck looking thing. It's actually quite short. It's quite stubby looking. Let's spawn in another one. There we go. And another one. Another one. Don't know why I'm spawning these in. Then we have the Shyster PMP 600, which is based on the Chrysler 300C, which, again, I thought was in GTA 5, but apparently it isn't. In fact, yeah, that front end definitely doesn't screen GTA 5 to me at all. That looks very dated on that front end and incredibly ugly. Good Lord. Okay, let's move away from that one to the Shih Tzu NRG 900, which is the classic bike from GTA. I don't know why they did not have the NRG 900 back in GTA 5. This was like the bike to have in Vice City. All the other bikes in this game just feel slow, but this one actually feels pretty fast. This is probably my favorite bike, actually. Gotta love the NRG 900. Okay, next up is the Übermacht Rebler, which is not that bad. In fact, that looks very similar to the one that I just thought was the latest DLC car, wasn't it? Oh, wow, that front end is very dated. Oh, yeah, this is definitely a GTA 4 car. And then we have the Übermacht Sentinel, which again, oh, that's a two-door. Yeah, that's not so bad. Ah, this looks like the old classic M3s. I can't tell you what E number that is of the BMW things. I can never remember the E's. E39 M5 is about the only E I can remember in the BMW family. But this is definitely supposed to be an M3 of some sort. At least on the front. Not too sure about the back. So, we're finally getting closer. Now we have the Vapid Bobcat, which is a classic that is... Ah, so the front is different on this one. The back is very similar to the Bobcat that we already have, but this front end is definitely more of an 80s Silverado, I think, actually. So that's pretty cool. Then we have the Vapid Cabby, which is the big old minivan version of the taxi, which again, actually, those black wheels look pretty nice on that. That looks pretty pimping. Then we have the Vapid Contender, which is another pickup truck. I'm sorry about this huge menu. A simple menu is not a good-looking menu mod, I've got to say. So this is the Vapid Contender. Then we have the Vapid Fortune. There's so many Vapids to get through. This is the Fortune. Another car that I quite liked, actually. Can't tell you what it's based on, though, but I'm going to say something Ford and 90s. Maybe an old 90s Taurus, maybe? I don't know. Thunderbird? I'm not so sure. Then we have the Vapid Huntley, which is something that was brought back into GTA 5 in one of the DLCs. But again, this one does look slightly older and slightly different as well. Then we have the Vapid Interceptor, which is the civil police variant, which I assume does have lights. It does not. Okay, well, it's just a whatever civil police variant means. Maybe that was because this was supposed to be a police car, but they've made a normal family person civilian going version. I guess that's what that means. And then on to the final few. We have the Vapid Stannier, which is, that's the classic. Oh, in fact, there isn't a taxi version and there isn't a police version. This was supposed to be the one. In fact, maybe this is because that one was already in GTA 5. Maybe this is just the sort of civilian version, because I definitely recognize that one. Then we have the Steed, which is a big old truck with the classic front end, which looks very similar to the ones we had in GTA 3. I think also, in fact, Vice City didn't have it. In fact, yeah, probably just GTA 3 and GTA 4, actually. But that is a very recognizable front end of the old classic trucks. Then we have the brilliant Uranus, one of the best cars from GTA 4. And as you can see, unlike the one that I started with, this one doesn't have the front lights, it doesn't have the side skirts, it doesn't have the big spoiler, and it doesn't have the fancy wheel. So this one was a tunable one. Then we have the Vapid Yankee, which is a big old truck again, like that, which we can get with all the different stuff on the side, which is awesome. And then a pickup variant of the Yankee. Oh, that's actually, it's stuck.
Start, you piece of crap.
Oh, it's stuck and now it's broken. Oh, there we go. Now it's working. And then we have the Western Company Hell Tours Maverick, which again, that is a helicopter. And yeah, is that graphic on the side supposed to be? I think that's supposed to be Liberty City, actually. I think that was supposed to be one of their tour helicopters. Then we have the Western Motorcycle Company Angel, which is pretty nice. Another one of these bikes added in. Then we have the Freeway, which is actually quite nice looking bike. And then we have the Hell Fury, which looks pretty nice as well. Oh, actually, I like that front end. That's nice. I like that one. And then for the final three, the Willard Marbell, which is stuck. Come on, get out of it. Get out of it. Now this one. Oh, this thing. If this was a lowrider at Benny's, that would be amazing. This is a definite lowrider contender, because this looks awesome. Oh, girlfriend jet skis up there. Yeah, this looks absolutely cool. Really like that one. And then for the final two, we have the Solaire, which is very much a 90s Escort. I think that's supposed to be, or a 90s Taurus. Very Escort themed at the back. Not sure what that's supposed to be at the front. Man, that's ugly. That is ugly. But then again, the old Escorts were ugly. And I'm talking about the US spec Escort, not the UK one. And then the Willard to finish, which again is definitely another one of those lowrider contenders. This thing definitely would suit some hydraulics. Yeah, in fact, if we actually go on this side bit, you can actually see what it would look like with the hydraulics, where it's like that. Yeah. Yeah, I like it. Right, let's try and find a few of these to tune up and modify. Hopefully there's some cool stuff that we can find. Okay, so I thought to start, I'd take the Willard in, and hopefully we can get some really cool lowrider stuff in this, but probably not. But let's have a look. And the amazing thing is, this stuff was not tunable in GTA 4, because we did not have tuning garages, at least not that I remember. So this is a nice new addition. Oh god, this car looks awesome. So this one actually just has normal stuff. There we go, just the usual tuning and suspension. But competition suspension, why is that low at the back? Is that just the design of the car? But that looks really weird, because it's all low at the back. I'm not sure what that's about. So there's not much you can do to this one, but I do want to see what it looks like with Slam It On, so it can even all that out. Oh yeah! Nice! I like it. I like it. That's pretty cool looking. Okay, so let's try and go through some of these that I wanted to check out. First of all, the Feltzer is something that I want to see if we can get this looking close to the one in GTA 5, or if this is really just going to look like the old bog standard version that it is. And this one doesn't really have much. No, it doesn't really have anything. Okay, we can exit that one again then. Yeah, it's definitely gonna be trying and error trying to find these, but hopefully we can find one that's got some parts that we can add on to it. Let's give the Shafter a try. Now, the interesting thing about this one is the engine. Can you hear that? There's a V12 in this thing. It really does not look like a V12, but yeah, I actually quite like this in the four-door version, to be honest. I quite like how it's stretched out compared to the two-door version that we have. And, oh, there is stuff to do. Awesome. So we have front bumpers, where we have just one custom front bumper. Then we have one custom rear bumper. I think in GTA 4, I think these were all there, but they just sort of spawned randomly on the cars and you couldn't really add or take them off yourself. but I might be wrong. Then we have all the engine stuff. Then we have grill. Yeah, okay, we can go for a custom grill. I think it's supposed to be a Mercedes, isn't it? I think that's what it's supposed to be based on. Then we have skirts, custom skirts, suspension. We're not that down. Transmission, turbo, wheels. Let's go for some nice wheels on this one. Not short wheels are really going to suit this thing, actually. This looks kind of weird when it's all modified. Maybe that. They look like they could be sort of standard-looking wheels from a higher spec version. And then we'll respray this in a nicer color. There we go. Dark blue. Very similar to the color that I did the Uranus earlier. But it is such a nice car. I'm quite feeling blue cars at the moment. I went through a stage of not thinking blue was cool at all. Now I'm quite digging blue. That's looking nice. I like it. Okay, let's try and find another one then. Okay, I'm very curious about the Ferocci, so let's see if this has got anything going for it. Oh, it's got stuff for it. Okay, bumpers. Well, we have front bumpers. We have a huge front splitter on that thing. Okay, then we have a little addition for the rear. Oh, it's actually got JDM VIP written on the... Oh, wow. Okay, that's cool. Then we have the engine upgrades. I'm not even going to bother with all these because we're not going to be testing speeds and stuff, so that's not really relevant. Exhausts. Well, we've got some custom ones. We've got this one, and then we've got a nice big one. We'll go for the nice big one. On the grill, we have a D-badge thing. I quite like cars with badges. I actually, 9 times out of 10, despise D-badged cars. It is just, everyone thinks, oh, it looks cleaner. It doesn't. It looks plainer. Badges for the win, but not too many badges, because I saw a car earlier that had chrome badges stuck all over it, and it looked utterly shite. It looks shite. Okay, so then we have... Let's go for a respray. Oh, we've got a secondary color on this one. So let's go for some simple colors. Maybe go for a nice anthracite black. And then on the secondary color... Oh! Oh! It's going to be the standard set of wheels. Well, that's interesting. We go for some red. But actually, I want to change the wheels in a minute anyway. Then on the skirts, we have some nice big skirts. On the spoiler... Wow, we've got a nice selection here. We've got this one. Which, oh, that's the sort of spoiler I usually go for. Good old ducktail. Then we have this one. This one, which actually looks quite nice. And then that one, which is a nice drag spoiler. I think, although that is quite nice, I think we'll go for the ducktail. There we go. Suspension. Got to drop it all the way down. Probably will you slam it in a minute. And this is a ticker turbo one, but although we won't be using it really. Let's go for some high-end wheels. This is supposed to be some sort of like VIP Bipu thing. These wheels are very VIP and Bipu. In fact, these are as well. I'm going to go for those. Look at that. And I think that's going to be pretty much it. Let's go to exit. Yeah. Oh, wow. I'm not going to do too many of these because actually I quite like the idea that you guys can download this and try and find some of your own. But let's just go to slam it. I'm going to try just a couple more. Slam it is... Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Okay, that is awesome. Look how slam that is. That is completely... It's completely ridiculous, but I like it. I like it. I don't care if it looks weird or people are going to call me a racer. I'm going to say I like it. In real life, I probably wouldn't. But for the sake of this game, it looks mental enough that I like it. So there we go. And I'll tell you what, it still looks nice in its standard form like that without the crazy drop. It still looks amazing like that. Okay, so I definitely want to try out, I think it's the Chavos. Yeah, the Chavos. I want to try the Chavos, the Hakumai, and then one more after that. And I think that will be it because this video is already getting to crazy lengths. And, oh, this one has stuff as well. Okay, so we've got this little bumper here. Oh, wow. Okay, that's a nice little tuner style front bumper or little front splitter edition thing. Then we have, let's just go for a nice respray. Let's go for some metallic. I'm thinking bluish silver for this. And I think that the secondary color is going to be that color at the top. Let's see. Yes, it is. Okay, so we can actually have that all matching, but I quite like that in the black, actually. On the spoilers, well, we have this one or this one. Yeah, this is going to look weird. It's not going to look right. It's going to look a bit wrong. And then that's pretty much it. So just the bumper. And was it the... Yeah, it was the front bumper and the spoiler. That's pretty much it. There you go. I'll stick some smaller tuning wheels on this one just so it looks a bit weird. There we go. Let's quit that out and go and try and test out the Hakumai, which I'm definitely a lot more excited about. This looks very Toyota. It looks very sort of Corolla Levin Toyota look. That's definitely the vibe I'm getting from that thing. Okay, onto the Hakumai, which I'm very excited about. I so hope that there's stuff for this. And there is. So on the bumpers, oh my God. Okay, we have this one, which is just a nice little splitter. Looks nice. Then we have that one with some fog lights, all the fog lights and the splitter. I think we'll just go with the splitter. I think no fog lights for that one. Engine, well, this is not really relevant. Exhaust, we have performance exhaust, which is just adding another one in. Then we have a big old spoiler with a burnt tip, and then just a slightly smaller one. I don't like the old burnt tip look, but let's just go for it. Let's just go for it and make it a bit of a tuner vehicle. On the respray, do we really want to change the colour? I assume that that's going to be just the bottom and... Yeah, bottom and top. In fact, let's try and find gold. Okay, in fact, actually not gold, maybe bronze. And then on the top, I'm going to go for... In fact, black and bronze doesn't look as good here as it does in real life, actually. Well, the gold's kind of okay, but I'm not entirely sure... Yeah, I was trying to make that look like some sort of like old 80s style thing, but it didn't really work out. Then we have a roll cage, which is pretty cool. And some skirts, custom skirts, spoilers, a huge selection. We got this one, nice little one. That one, which is pretty cool. That one, which is the secondary color. And that one, I'm going to go for that one. So that looks pretty nice. Then we have suspension. Let's just knock it down. There we go. And some wheels. And none of these wheels really fit, to be quite honest with you, so I don't really know what to go for. I might actually just go with the tuner ones, but they are just a bit small looking. Let's just go for, I don't know. Let's go for some of them. Let's go for some of them. There's the Hakumai. Not actually happy with that paint scheme, to be quite honest with you. Maybe you guys will like it. I don't know. Let me know in the comment section. Okay, we're going to test out the last one, and it's going to be the Maibatsu Vincent, because, of course, it has the Gallant front end. And I love those front ends on the Gallants. It just looks so mean. And angry. Like, if you saw that in your review mirror, you'll be like, yeah. Well, then not so much this one, but the one in real life does look a lot meaner. And this doesn't really have anything. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Well, let's try and find one that we can modify then. I was hoping to end it on some sort of, like, really cool build, but that's a shame. As I thought this car would look quite nice with some little bits added, nice little splitter on the front or something like that. Oh, well. Well, let's try the Vapid Fortune. Hopefully, we'll have more luck. If I can't get it this time, then I'm just going to have to end it. Because this video is... Well, the recording is almost an hour long, which is just ridiculous. I can't imagine any of you are actually watching this far in. And this one doesn't really have any. Oh, well. Well, let's just go for some nice wheels. Let's just try and make this look relatively cool, if it's possible. I don't know. Should we go for, like, a VIP look again? I don't know if it's going to work. Let's see. Go for competition suspension, which doesn't really drop it that much at all. We'll go for a nice midnight purple, which looks really nice. And there wasn't much else, was it, too? Yeah, let's just go out and go you slam it. And here we go. Boop. Okay, well, there's a nice slam down version of it anyway. That's very 90s. That's very 90s, early 2000s. And because, I mean, this day and age is what people might consider racer, even though that word is really misused these days. But, yeah, this is what I grew up in. This is like, you know, this sort of thing. Like a lowrider that's had big, massive chrome wheels on it and was completely slammed with some nice paint. That was a very sort of late 90s, early 2000s thing to do. So, I sort of like that because I grew up with that. But there we go. I'm sure you guys would disagree. I would love you guys to let me know what car you thought was the best. Which one did you miss the most in GT4? Perhaps there was a car that was in GT4 that was not in this pack that you think should be added. Just let me know in the comment section below. And if you have watched the entirety of this video, you are amazing, first of all. In fact, there it is. Hang on. There's that back end. Ah, there it is. That's the back end of the... Oh, so that's the Feltzer. Hang on. Hang on a minute. So it's the shaft... Ah, see, look. Ah, the back end of the Shafter is what we have for the back end of the Feltzer in GTA 5. There it is. They're incredibly similar. There we go. Yeah, well, how about that? Well, yeah, there we go. If you've watched this entire video, then you are truly amazing. Oh, I just realized I still got Samit on because the handling was really weird just then. Yeah, you are amazing people. Give yourself a pat on the back for being just absolutely amazing. And thank you so much for sticking with me. I know that the videos have been very scarce lately. I know I've even mentioned this lately. It's just, I'm just having a bit of a down time, but it's not going to be like forever. So I appreciate all of you for sticking around. You all mean so much to me. You do not believe how much it's mad. I'm loving all these cars. Look at them all. There are so many GTA 4 cars spawning now. This is fantastic. I guess as we've sort of been driving them about, they've sort of like turned into the temporary car list. There's just countless of them. It's like driving in GTA 4 now with all these cars around. Look at them all. There's loads of them.
Well, there we go. Thank you all very much for watching. If you have watched the entirety of this thing, say, Soiler. Say Soiler in the comment section. Whatever, I don't know. The thing is, a lot of you cheat. I believe that you cheat because, by the way, YouTubers can see retention stats. We know how much of the video that you've seen. And sometimes the amount of comments that say the word at the end, it does not fit in with the retention of the video. So, come on, if you have genuinely watched to the end, let me know. Otherwise, just don't lie about it. There's no need to. It doesn't matter. But thank you anyway if you have watched this whole thing. You are brilliant. And that's going to be it for this video. I'll see you all next time. Goodbye!